Zero. Hello and welcome to another edition of Bits and Banter. This time we are looking at doing something completely different from a perspective of the economy and the business. Why are we doing it? Because as you probably already know, Bits and Banter is a property owned and operated by our company called Stratagens Digital Solutions Limited. And we are doing this because we believe that there would be a lot of people out there who can benefit from this type of shows. So in this show, we are going to talk about the COVID pandemic, which started last March and it has sort of continued. Lockdowns have continued. In between, there were phases where there was no lockdown. Business started, then it came back again. So my question here today is, the discussion point is, has the pandemic been a disaster completely for the Indian economy, or is there an opportunity out there which people are not looking at? With me, I have my fellow director on Stratagens, Mr. Subhashish Bhattacharya, who's a business consultant for the last 25, 30 years. So Subhashish, simple question, is it a disaster or is it an opportunity?
See, it is a disaster as well as opportunity, but I would say largely it's a huge opportunity. See, it's a disaster because it has exposed a huge vulnerability of the Indian economy. A very large section of our population cannot fend for themselves even for 3-4 days in case of an economic stoppage.
Yeah.
Okay, so that is the vulnerability. It makes the economy very, very vulnerable. It removes the resilience from the economy. So that is the weakness. That is the disaster.
Mm-hmm.
The opportunity part is, it gives us, it does not leave us any option but to take the corrective action.
Yeah.
Okay. Today, we don't have an option. We have to take corrective action.
Yes. Yeah. So let me ask you a question here. Where exactly would you sort of pin this problem? I mean, pin the blame. I don't want to use the word blame because it sounds like we are sort of playing the blame game. But then, to what would you pin this the key responsibility for what we are seeing now? Like you said, I mean, the fact that people cannot fend for themselves. So where do you pin this blame? Pin this issue to?
See, Raj, the reason is very interesting. We are one of the largest economies in the world, right? However, the sizes of the economic unit are very, very small. You look at any sector of the economy, you will find very small economic unit in terms of size. For example, agriculture. We are supposed to be an agrarian society.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, if you look at agriculture, 48% of all the land holdings are smaller than a quarter of a hectare. Now, a family of five, which is supposed to be the average Indian family size, family of five cannot survive on such a small farm, even during normal time.
Yeah.
So during pandemic, it's a crisis. You know, they can only look up at the government and ask for support.
Yeah, true.
Okay. Similarly, if you go beyond agriculture, look at the business, right? You'll find that 72% of all enterprises in India are own account enterprises, OEs. Okay. Now, OEs do not employ a single hired worker on a regular basis.
Yeah.
Right. Therefore, all those working in OEs are self-employed.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, the average value added in these enterprises in terms of salary or daily wages or whatever you call them, is barely sufficient to give a family of five a subsistence level existence during normal time.
Yes.
Right? So in a crisis, what would they do? Right? When the economy stops, raise your hands and look at the government.
Yeah, very true. Very true. Very true. So, I mean, is it true? I mean, so you mentioned OAEs, you are right, because you go to villages, you go to towns. I mean, you always find these small businesses, which are very small businesses, which are catering to a very small audience. So is this true even for the other businesses, other enterprises which actually hire people?
See, when you talk of enterprise, what are we talking about? We are talking about 1% large enterprise. Right, and MSMEs, what we call micro, small, and medium enterprise.
Yeah.
Now, if you look at this micro, small, and medium enterprise, The medium part, you know, which employ, let's say, 200 or more workers, is very, very small. Right? Majority, about 80-85%, is micro and small enterprise. Right? Now, if you look at the Indian workforce, which is huge, right? Only 9% of that workforce are actually employed with enterprises who employ 20 or more workers.
Yeah.
Okay. So they are actually, the Indian economy is being funded by these micro, small enterprises and OEs. Okay. Which means you have about 400 million workers, right, who work in such small enterprises that their subsistence during normal times, as I said, is a problem. Right. And during pandemic, it's a complete disaster.
Yeah, that's true. So, I mean, even if you look at the scenario, I mean, whatever help the government pushes out for small enterprises from time to time, they don't seem to be very effective. I mean, right? Isn't that true?
Because of the sheer numbers, you know, if you have so many small enterprises, there's nothing. For example, you know, 2015, the Modi government launched something called Mudra Loan Scheme. Which was aimed at filling this gap. Because, you know, such small enterprises, no bank would like to fund them.
Yeah.
Right. Because the cost of funding them, the cost of giving them a loan, you know, assessing their credit worthiness, and then following up for the repayment.
Yeah.
It does not make sense. You know, it is not cost effective.
So
no bank would like to fund. So what happened? The government launched something called Mudra Loan Scheme.
Okay.
Now, till November last year, or rather October last year, 31st October last year, the Mudra Loan Scheme had disbursed 10.24 trillion rupees to 208 million accounts. Okay. Now, which means you have disbursed 49,100 or something like that per account. Now, such a small disbursement cannot help the enterprises scale up. It can only engage them in subsistence level activity.
Correct. True.
So what happens? You take loan, you still continue to just barely exist. And then when there is a pandemic, you can't even pay back that.
And even that the amount of the loan is just enough for you to sort of meet maybe one cycle of growth. The moment there is any disruption, that money goes out of hands, right? It could be more rains, less rains, could be anything, right?
And what happens is, you know, it is one thing feeds into other. If you have large amount of your workforce, almost majority of your workforce work on enterprises which only give them subsistence. Right, bare minimum subsistence, whether it is agriculture or business. Okay. Then what happens when they become consumer to the business? Right. They can't spend too much. So, you know, large amount of business is done on credit.
Correct.
And when the disaster happens, nobody is able to pay. Your entire cash flow is stopping.
Yeah. Circulation, cash circulation completely
cash
sort
circulation
of evaporates.
Cash circulation.
Yeah, you're right. So my question now to you is, what would be a solution for this? What is it that can actually happen from here on, where you said this is an opportunity? You specifically said this is a bigger opportunity here. What is it in your mind that you call an opportunity?
See, today, Indian economy does not have any option other than scaling.
Yeah.
Right. They have to scale up. India as a nation has to survive, the economy has to scale. Which means the micro, small, you know, what we call local commerce.
Yeah.
The local commerce, which is the backbone of Indian economy, has to scale up. You know, they have to go beyond the boundaries of local and scale up their business. Right. And herein also comes the opportunity. See, till today, what was happening, if you are a micro or a small enterprise, right? Our policies for 70 years have been to keep them as micro and small enterprises.
Yeah.
Right. So we will incentivize them to stay small.
Okay.
So if you are a micro and small enterprise, you get subsidies, you get electricity discounts, you get tax breaks, right?
Mm.
You get everything.
Mm.
The moment you cross a turnover, your tax level goes up,
mm.
right? Your electricity goes up, the commercial rate of electricity pay, or everything goes.
Mm-hmm.
So what would happen? Indian businesses, Indian entrepreneurs, they mm. learned how to keep their business small. In fact, they were very creative. Ek turnover cross kiya, how to break the business into three businesses, mm-hmm. four businesses, so that each business remains small.
Yeah.
Right. And that is what is hitting us back to.
Mm-hmm.
Now, today, the government has also realized that this is no longer an option.
Mm-hmm.
It has to stay, the businesses have to scale up. Right.
Mm-hmm.
And I think the environment is just.
Yeah, yeah.
The government is already working on the laws, right?
Mm.
Labor laws. Labor laws was another issue. It wouldn't allow big companies, FDIs, to come into India.
Mm.
No, one of the biggest reasons was the labor law.
Mm.
Another reason was tax laws, right?
Mm.
Now
mm.
the tax laws have been reformed,
mm.
right? Labor laws are being reformed.
Mm.
Okay. As a result of which, the environment is right and the opportunities are ripe for scaling up. See what mm. happens, a local business, a small or a micro or a OAE, operates only in a specific locality. So mm. they are local company,
mm.
right? Now, these guys are not able to go beyond the boundaries of their local area simply mm. because it was too expensive. You know, mm. if I am in Hyderabad,
mm.
and I want to sell in Goa mm. or I want to sell in Delhi, mm. then I have to travel to Delhi,
mm.
right? There is a cost of traveling. I mm. have to stay there, so there is a cost of accommodation,
mm-hmm.
right? I have to go around the city meeting customers.
Mm.
The cost itself, as I have to open an office, the cost of real estate is too high.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, today...
So just to add to that, I'll just add one sentence. I mean, the way I saw it was the opportunity cost of expanding was usually way below, in their eyes at least, way below the operational cost that they thought would come, right?
Correct.
That was the way it was. Correct. Yeah. Yeah.
So
go
on
ahead.
One side, the government is incentivizing you to stay small,
mm.
right? So there is no motivation. On the other side, the opportunity cost of growth is too high.
Mm-hmm.
Three times unaffordable.
Yeah.
Now, what the pandemic has done is, it has ensured that people start working from home,
mm.
right? So therefore, digitalization has become the input.
Mm.
Today, the advantage that all these local businessmen, local commerce have,
mm.
is they can use digital platform, which is well within their reach,
mm.
right? And overcome this cost of growth.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Today, they don't have to travel to Delhi. They don't have to travel to New York, right?
Yeah.
They can sit at their home and yeah. access the market.
Yeah.
Right. See, we have launched this e-samudai.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, what is e-samudai doing? It has provided them with a digital platform
mm.
using which not only they can scale up within the locality, they mm. can cross the boundaries of locality so easy.
Correct.
Right. So today, the opportunity is there. The environment is there. All that is required is entrepreneurs have to address their mindset. You know, mm. they must realize that unless we grow, we will mm. not survive. Another yeah. pandemic, see, this corona is coming in waves and waves.
Yeah, true.
So two more lockdowns means the entire local commerce is finished.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So therefore, they don't have an option other than expanding, right?
Yeah.
Scaling up. Scaling up is the mantra. And today, the opportunity is ripe. It is within your affordability to scale up.
Mm.
Right, because of availability of digital platforms like e-samudai.
Yeah.
Okay. And government is coming up with the supporting policies.
Yeah. So one of the things I think
is a yeah. wonderful yes. policy by government. It helps yeah. you overcome your cash flow challenges.
Yes.
But the problem is very few MSMEs mm. actually are aware or have the mindset to take advantage.
Yeah. So it is a mindset thing. So one of the things which I would also say is that this the opportunity could actually go the way of people who are probably first time entrepreneurs, people who have never been entrepreneurs, youngsters who sort of see one of the things that happened in the during the pandemic was since you could work from home, many mm. youngsters who were working in companies or in segment sectors, they actually went from the larger cities to their smaller villages, because right. internet is available, mobile is available. So they're sitting there and working. So these could be the next generation entrepreneurs who digitize the economy further and create jobs locally. Mm. And the most important thing is if you create jobs locally, you won't have the migration to the cities. The cities won't be bursting at its seams. So overall, I think this is a you're right. This is a fantastic opportunity because
look at what Corona has done.
Yes.
70 years, healthcare was not addressed by successive government.
Yes.
Right.
Yeah.
Today there is no option. You have to.
You don't. Yeah. Exactly.
And it is happening.
Yes.
Right. What India has achieved in last 1 year, they have not achieved in last 70.
See, that is the point. Somewhere this change happens. I mean, I think so. Your point is right because it didn't happen because you did it. You planned for it. It happened because something sort of came and stared you in the face, and the change started happening. So I think we'll leave it there, and we'll come back with further shows around the same topic or similar topic. So thanks for watching, and share your comments, share your thoughts, and like and share the video, and we'll come back to you soon. So thanks, Subhashish, for being on the call, and
thank you, Raj.
We'll come back soon. Thanks. Bye-bye. Perfect. Adios.
Bye.
Bye.